Field picks up speed. Here they come. Off and pacing, good start inside for Aaron Wood-Eve as he charges off the gate. Leading alongside is Colby Two-Step, speed far outside from Aviator and from Magical Arthur. Charging out of Sports Box 2, off stride, Aviator. Aviator's made a break. Sports Box is off stride. He was bothered too, it appeared. Going into that first turn, out to grab the lead from the far outside, it's Magical Arthur on top. Racing up in second is Aaron Wood-Eve, then third is Colby Two-Step. Dropped in fourth when Stonebridge Helios, here's a quarter pole move, was on the attack with Aaron Wood-Eve. 27-4 the opening quarter, and they're into the backstretch. Aaron Wood-Eve takes command. Back into second goes Magical Arthur. Here's Colby Two-Step, now third outside, with Stonebridge Helios tracking cover in a good spot from in fourth, and he'll tip three wide right now. Then it's back inside from in fifth to find Better Have My Money. Towards the inside from in sixth, that's Bootlegger Charlie. Then Bob Blah Blah and Century Inspector. Halftime, 55-3. Solid speed for the youngsters as they go into the final turn. They're chasing favorite Stonebridge Helios. He's got the racetrack. Second inside to Colby Two-Step. Aaron Wood-Eve is third. He'll pop back to the outside. Picking up his cover goes Better Have My Money. Magical Arthur in at the rail. Then we go back to Bootlegger Charlie. Bob Blah Blah and Century Inspector, they're on their way to three quarters, and Stonebridge Helios the one to catch. It's Stonebridge Helios on top. Pressure from Aaron Wood-Eve in second. Back into third, it's Colby Two-Step. Then outside, Better Have My Money fourth. Three quarters clocked in 1:24, and they're into the stretch. Still there, Stonebridge Helios. Pressure from Aaron Wood-Eve on the outside. In at the rail in third is Colby Two-Step. Brushing up late now, trying to find a seam is Magical Arthur. Deep stretch, Stonebridge Helios. Outside is Aaron Wood-Eve. Here comes Magical Arthur and Bob Blah Blah. About time, Bob. Bob Blah Blah rallies by for a super final score in 1:53.
We'll get Sylvan if I can get your friend.
Yep.
If you can stick around, that'd be great. Get some immediate reactions.
Hey, thank you.
Perfect. Excellent.
We're going to do a trophy picture. if Bob, if you could just put that on that table, we're going to go over and take pictures.
Okay.
Are you okay?
Yep.
You're okay.
Yeah.
Go back. Where's Jesse? Well,
she's at home.
Oh. Perfect.
No. Everybody jumped off the bandwagon. Except the right people.
What do you mean, everybody?
No, I said except the right people. I said.
I'll take these and I'll take the horseback.
Okay, very good.
Okay, we'll take a shot here.
Here in the Winback Farm Winter Circle with winning driver Sylvain Filion pulls off the upset here with Bob Loblaw. And Sylvain, just talk about what we just saw happen in the stretch there. And from your vantage point, what was going on?
You know what? My only concern was the last turn. I was just hoping to get through the last turn, still pacing. And when I hit the top of the stretch, I know he's a very good and very fast horse. And I knew I could, there was a possibility I could beat them by, even I was so back. But he's got so much speed and so much guts. And you got to give credit to Ken there. He's done a great job with him.
And you've done a great job with him too, Sylvain. We'll give you some credit as well. But I want to talk about the decision. You got off of a horse in Magical Arthur that's been racing fantastic. And I think that just goes to show the confidence you had in this colt.
Absolutely. I knew if he could stay at it, he's probably one of the best ones in the bunch. And I had confidence in him, and it worked out.
All right, well, congratulations. Enjoy this latest super final victory. As we bring in man of the hour, Ken Middleton, look at him, still posing for pictures. Well, he's a popular man. Kenny, I don't know if you had that fireman pole. You were down here in a hurry from upstairs.
I'll tell you what, when you, it's a test of speed coming down. Going up is going to be the challenge.
Did you feel better coming into this race that you had this horse ready to roll, that he was going to get through this mile tonight?
You know what, there was only one start this year where I really had a little bit of trepidation going into a race, and that was after the Battle of Waterloo. He got a little bit sick. It's really been frustrating. I haven't been able to pinpoint why exactly he was making breaks. You don't want to go out and make a bunch of changes. In all honesty, I thought he made breaks for three different reasons in those three different races. The Champlain, I thought he was pinching somewhere. The next start was the Metro. I think he just got claustrophobic in behind all those horses. There was just an army of horses on the track that night, and he was in a bad spot as far as the kind of horse he is. And the Flamborough, on the sloppy track there, it was hard as a rock that night. It was just a bad track. So not to make excuses, but I've been busting my hump trying to get him back, and here he is.
We know you as a man behind the scenes always through the years, analyzing races like this, calling races like this, doing interviews like I'm doing just now. But now to be on this side of it and enjoying the success you're having with friends of yours, maybe just sum up how that feels.
Well, that's kind of what I want to do. I took it upon myself to make it a goal. We all have goals here at Woodbine Entertainment. Mine was to bring more people in the industry. There's a lot of people that are curious about getting involved in horse ownership. You can do it on a big scale. You can do it on a small scale. The stable.ca proved that, and since other people have done that. So I've made it kind of a goal of mine to try and bring in some great people and enjoy, you know, this great sport, because it really is fun. It's fun whether you're sitting in the grandstand eating a hamburger or betting a couple bucks or getting involved in horse ownership and doing the same thing. So I'd encourage everybody, now's the time of year. All the yearlings are selling right now. So if you're ever curious about getting involved, now's the time to do it.
What about your buddy Bill Galvin? What would he be saying right now?
He'd be saying, great work, buddy. We are great friends, great partners. I miss him dearly. This is a race for him. I miss my dad, too. He'd be proud of me. My mom's at home. She's one of the backbones of my success. I love her dearly, and I thank her for all her help. Becky Rose, my niece. I've got a great blacksmith in Jeff Boyd. I've got great vets in Dr. John Hennessy and Dr. Ian Moore. Rob McKenzie is another guy who helped me break my colts this year and train them down. So did my partner, Jeff Seibel. And I've taken on other partners. My brother got involved. Dave Walls, who calls the races at Hiawatha Horse Park, and one of his buddies, James Grant. It's been a great ride. A lot of fun.
Well, congratulations. I'm proud of you, too, buddy.
Enjoy it. Oh, I appreciate it so much. Thank you.
All right. There's Ken Middleton and his team. Congratulations to them. Bob Loblaw capturing the two-year-old Colton Gelding OSS Super Final.